Thank you very much. A very good morning and a warm thankful heart to all my Almighty, and then to Dr. Lim, and then to our DXN family who has given me the opportunity to be there for you and with you to share some of the information, minimum of it, that I can squeeze in about an hour. So thank you all, and we'll be sharing some of the important factors that why I have chosen DXN as a part of my medical practice, and what am I and what I'm doing nowadays. As you have, thank you very much from Mrs. Laszlo, that she has given very warm words for me. Thanks a lot. But I'm still a student of medicine and naturopathy, so I still learn from everyone. So it's a continuation of my wellness awareness programs. Today I have concise them from my field as well as from the wellness industry, that is reproductive health. And as you know, being a gynecologist, it is now utmost sincerity to work for it and to prevent the things naturally. So what is reproductive health? As per the definition by WHO, World Health Organization, it is defined as the total well-being and the proper functioning of the reproductive organs in all phases of life, including a complete state of mental, physical, and social well-being. Now, this is a WHO organization that is now a very warm topic today, but I believe it should add one word of spirituality also into it, because unless and until you are calm and peaceful, you cannot be enjoying the health totally. What is the objective of reproductive health and how to maintain it? Basically, today I'm going to give you a comprehensive and factual information under the umbrella of holistic and natural support to how to cope up with the changing situations from neonate life till the menopausal life, and the diversity and the intensity of the reproductive health, how you can maintain it. Basically, generally it is assumed that reproductive health should include family planning, counseling, further planning, information, education, lots of other things. For me, family planning is not only the shortening of the family size, it is also a part of making a family, where my role comes in as an IVF specialist to plan a family with the the environment. If there is something deficient, we overcome it by nature plus medical facilities available, and then we should be blessed with one. So it needs education, it needs counseling, communication, and above all, there's a big factor now in medical industry which is least bothered by the people is prevention. So why to prevent and how to prevent, these are another topic which will take a lot of time. But prevention of gynae and obstetric complications also is a part of physical fitness. And to treat the reproductive infections, STDs, and just to have a successful, beautiful married life and to have a responsible parenthood. Now, the reproductive health problems nowadays, they are associated with the deformities and the population situation in some countries. But look at the heart for those people who don't have one baby. So we can understand in the last 25, 26 years, I've been with the couples who are sometimes blessed, sometimes not blessed, because there are two types of subfertilities that we are confronting. Is one, when they get pregnant, they lose it. And the one where they don't get to get pregnant. And what are the reasons behind, I've discussed a little bit in detail, and where nature and their help of nature and the food comes in. The ill health of the mother being the first thing to give a compromised baby or compromised health of the mother. Early marriages in some countries before attaining puberty, also one of the issues, and increased mortality during the antenatal or postnatal period because of lots of complications is an issue. Just to give you an example of my country, every 30 minutes there is one woman who die of complications of pregnancy. So more than 300,000 babies die in the first month of their life, and 4 births per woman induced abortions are there. So a lot of complication, which needs a lot of interest and solutions to be provided by the public and by the government, but that is sometimes difficult. So my objective today is to promote the awareness of health in women. Why I'm confining myself to women, it's not that men are not important, but for me, the best man on earth is a woman, because she has to bear a lot. Why I say so? Because women stand for worried, overstressed, mostly bound morally, ethically, socially, and available for every responsibility and not paid for any in most of the countries, and not getting any information, care, respect, and time for herself. Somewhere down the line, 1/3 of our population of women are suffering one of these things nowadays, and they're not sometimes aware of it. So let's give them some health care at their doorstep. How do we get it? When should we get it? And who is going to provide that? What is the right time to give this to information of, for the good health, for the production, and how to prevent the ill effects of not being fertile? It all starts when the baby starts growing in the mother's womb. And then when the baby comes out, it is the adolescent period, which is the most vulnerable period, which is least handled fruitfully, and then comes to the reproductive age. Now, this age is a mirror picture of what has been this baby gone through in utero and in puberty, and then leading to a satisfied or a end of fertility period, menopause. In utero health means that a healthy mother is a generation blessing. We have to give her a good antenatal and postnatal care, and she can signal us with a good family. Then comes to the stage of adolescence, puberty, which is globally an issue now, and it's a time of opportunities and risk, promoting new developmental changes and sexual activity risks are there. So I define puberty as a personal confidential change, which is unavoidable, unexpected, unattended at times, and maybe sometimes unusual, unhealthy also. So biological changes are taking place, emotional changes are taking place, and relatively relationships are getting compromised. Are these treatable? Question. And are you yourself responsible for it? Then comes the reproductive age. This age is dependent on the previous backlog, what you have been given by your parents, and also what your lifestyle is giving you. It gives you the weight, it gives you a balance of height and weight. If it is not up to the mark, higher is the age, higher is the weight or BMI, lower is the chances of you being reproductive or fruitfully fertile. And then it's the relevant family history, which also dictates your reproductivity, and some of the factors of addiction, stress, social media, including it is an addiction itself now. You know, in my history, I've added Facebook and WhatsApp into addiction, because that is one of the compromise which we are giving to our generation. In future, we will not have relationships. We will be having only controlled time of media to meet our relations. And then comes to the most common causes of reproductive illnesses, which may be systemic endocrine tumors, autoimmune disorders, and maybe some certain traumas, including accidents, post-operative, or sometimes doctor-created, like she had an operation before marriage, lost her tube, lost her ovary, and now the reproductive system is compromised. Then comes the age of menopause, which is nothing but a departure of fertility and its beginning of a fragile life. But it can be full of fragrance. It can be taken positively with a beautiful legendary figure to teach people to maintain good health and have a graceful aging. How can we, our food, our nutrition, can beautify this beautiful concept of pregnancy and to get pregnant? The nutrition plays a great role to get pregnant, to be pregnant, to maintain the pregnant, and to help in lactation. What would be the objective? To have a good information and good management in a period of when you get the pregnancy. You have to watch your weight, you have to watch your baby's weight, and you have to recognize the additional energy, and you have to input some vitamins, mineral requirements to fulfill the nutritional needs of the pregnancy. And there are risk factors. Some women, they are having addictions, maybe reactionary to their social and psychological setbacks, whatever may be the reason, but they if they get pregnant, they are at a higher risk of nutritional compromise. So these they can be vegetarians, they can be smokers, they can be anorexic. The other medical part of a pregnant woman risk factors are excessive vomiting or weight loss or excessive weight gain, and then result of all that, dehydration, constipation, and enhancement of the pre-existing medical conditions. It all leads, all of these women should have proper medical checkups and all this. In UK, in your countries, you are so blessed to have a national, the NHS and the other public services for you, but in other parts of the world, this is not the case. The woman will go to the hospital only when it is needed, either near birth or maybe some in between one or two visits. Currently, they will not have any pattern of having a healthy antenatal period. So vitamin requirement, the caffeine, nausea, vomiting, heart, all these obstetrical history is very important to take care of. And then definitely physical examinations, evaluations can help them to permit a good antenatal period. And associated with all these pregnancy problems, the most common is nausea, vomiting. And there is a limitation of drug intake. We cannot give medications because it can have side effects for the baby. So when the blood levels of the pregnancy hormone increase, it gives rise to these all these symptoms. The strategies would be to have food changes, to have low fat change. You have a lot of fluids, and we have with our platform a very beautiful product, which you might have it in your countries also, by Noni fruit juice, Morinda citrifolia. We'll be talking it much more in a little bit of detail next slides. But the avoiding and the time of changing is the change of lifestyle and the change of food. Having a postural change, having a walk, loose fitting clothes, all these things in matter during pregnancy. Another problem in pregnancy is, which is commonly seen, is constipation or bowel habits irregularities, which is again as the result of a progesterone levels being higher in during pregnancy, and discomfort is already there. So fiber and fluid can take care. In our products, we have three products which can give you the compensation plan. If you are not eating proper diet, you can get this compensation with the spirulina, noni, and lion's mane to have a good gut motility. Now, you need energy in each trimester. Proteins to gain weight for the baby, and proteins to have a hormonal strength, and proteins to give you the buildup of the newborn as what it should be. So there is a persistent requirement in each trimester. Vitamin minerals requirement in pregnancy increase, and the recommended doses, as you can see, are there. And everybody of you must be aware of all the vitamins which are needed, from A to B7, B6, still lots of range of vitamins are there. But how many of us are taking care of that? Sometimes we don't even have time. We forget that we are carrying a double responsibility, one for ourselves to be ready for the labor, and the other is to have a healthy, normal baby so who can sustain the dilemmas of the world. If not, what will happen? If you are deficient of minimum example of folic acid, it can lead to all the complications of pregnancy. May it be a neural tube defect, or may it be the psychological setbacks in a child. B1, B6 deficiency, it can lead to ADHD. All these things are very, very important, and most of us know it. Deficiency of iron in third world countries, even in the well developed countries, malnutrition is the key of all the problems. Malnutrition doesn't mean that you are not healthy. Sometimes you are not taking what you should take. Taking something extra and taking something deficient will not get the balance out of your food. So iron in pregnancy is an essential element which gives you a risky life if it is not there. Deficiency increases the risk to mom and the baby, early to preterm delivery, low birth weight, and even the death of the baby. Deficiency of anemia, iron deficiency can lead to the biggest cause of death in antenatal period or postnatal period, fatigue, performances, and most of the women who are working can appreciate that, that during that work now they are getting tired. Physical signs will let them be, you know, coldness and the numbness and pallor and getting tired all the time and having babies with low IQs. So all these problems can be there, even the learning issues can be there. What we can do as a wellness ambassador, as a person, how to get this energy, how to get this growth proteins, and how to prevent all these problems, and can, is the medicine in answer to it? No. Essential micronutrition and the elements and the calcium and vitamins are a content of food. If you take it in a synthetic way, it will have its own side effects. Let's thankful to Dr. Lim to have this DXN products to work for us in pregnancy as well as in self-fertility. They provide not only the nutritive factor, but they provide the curative factors also from the root of the cell level. An egg and a sperm, people say in our scientific background that the first sign of sickness is infertility, because one egg and one sperm cannot join and cannot make a baby. So let DXN work on each and every platform of the cell to make you healthy and to make you a good mom and to have a sustained health and during pregnancy and later. A lot of products, maybe 200 products are there with us, which can overcome all these deficiencies, and you need to know about it. This time doesn't permit me to give you all the details of our beautiful products, but one only statement of our Dato, Dr. Lim, the biggest pillar of our DXN is Ganoderma lucidum, a mushroom of ancient traditional Chinese medicine, but it is one of the beautiful mushrooms, the miraculous mushroom of the world, which is was made for the kings. And now we are lucky enough that it is there at our doorstep, and it doesn't treat the disease, it treats the body, it works at the cell level, and the body itself manages the disease. So it protects health by many factors. See, what you get sick by toxins and by imbalances. And I add some iatrogenic factors, medicines, and your habits and your diet. But in the deep root cause of your illness, there is a toxic factor involved. So to detoxicate, Ganoderma lucidum is one of the biggest pillars. It gives you the ransom and handsome supply of antioxidants. What are antioxidants? Antioxidants are the substances which can detox ourselves and which can remove the effect of free radicals and the free radicals to decrease oxidative stress and help each cell to grow and to sustain the insults which are being given by us, by the environment, by the genetics, and by the chemicals that we have to take if we are ill. And all the basic supply to the for the nutrition and for your life are the blood vessels. So having immunity, immunomodulating effect, and having a very good effect on the blood vessels to let them dilate and provide you the best oxygen content, which can be given by Ganoderma. So we are going to study a little bit of Ganoderma today. It is a provider of general immunity. As we know, we get our immunity, our resistance by our police force inside. The police force, which is given by the WBCs and different types of blood cells, which are enhancing the resistance. And Ganoderma is a powerful immune modulator by the effect of its content of polysaccharides and ganoderic acid. It has the highest effect because it has interleukin 1 and 2. Now you see, if you get, just quote an example of hepatitis C, you have to have an interferon injections a day, which in my country cost about 10 to 15,000 per day, rupees. And it is there in ample amount in Ganoderma. So it increases interleukin, it increases interferon to fight back the immunity, whatever may be the reason. may it be a cancer cell, or may it be an allergic focus, or may it be the virus, whatever may be the insult, your immunity comes first to fight back. And the cells which are provided are made of proteins, and the protein is good quality back. Ganoderma, how it affects the blood vessels, it is mediated by the adenosine, which is a powerful vasodilator, and it's an energy provider. It increases the blood flow, macro and micro circulation. So that's how your organ function improves. And when you need a higher flow, especially when you are less mobile, if when you're aging, you need a good flow with a good oxygen content and a good micro nutrition. So that's an anti-aging process if you give your cells a good blood supply. For me, the biggest system, the biggest organ of your body is your blood vessel. And the blood vessels, if they are working well, no cell is going to resist a healthy life. We have one thing in our blood, which is platelet. Nowadays, everybody in the world is scared of thrombi, the clots, the micro clots, which are stuck in one of our fine capillaries, can lead to death, may it be in the brain, may it be in the eyes, may it be in the ears, or may it be in the heart and lungs, may it be in the liver. That area dies because this blood clot is going to stop the supply of oxygen. Ganoderma is an anti-platelet effect, where the platelets are making this extra thrombi, not routine platelet count will go down. So people sometimes ask me that if we keep on taking Ganoderma, that means we keep on bleeding. No. Don't forget that Ganoderma is an adaptogen. Adaptogen is a substance which adapts according to the requirement. It doesn't go beyond a limit of natural health. It takes care of its circulation. And once the circulation, like a thermostat of an air conditioner, when the temperature is reached, it sustains itself. It will not go beyond. So when the thermostat of any cell or a balance of any cell is out, the cell is sick. So Ganoderma is going to provide micro and macro circulation, preventing a good vascular damage, which can cause to disease. Apart from that, Ganoderma is a very powerful anti-inflammation. See, inflammation is the cause of pain, and it is a sign of a disease. Sometimes it is a sign of health, because it's a sign that makes you to go to a doctor. If you don't have pain, you will not know yet you are sick. It's a blessing in disguise, but when it goes beyond the pressure of sustainability or acceptance, then it becomes a disease, like in arthritis, like in degenerative disorders of brain, like in any disease which can lead to a chronic inflammation will have a sustained pain. So when you have something anti-inflammatory in your blood, it will reduce the pathological inflammation, which can be infection, leading to infection. So it will decrease the inflammation, and in return you get no pain. So that's one of the beautiful effects of Ganoderma. See, nowadays, non-steroidal anti-inflammatory agents that you are taking are a burden on your stomach. May it be paracetamol, may it be mefenamic acid, may it be valtaren, may it be brufen, whatever. They are beautiful anti-inflammatory non-steroidal drugs. But on the other hand, there are sometimes side effects on the stomach. Now, this is the best anti-inflammatory agent, Ganoderma lucidum, which is not only saving in the stomach, it is repairing the body by having an anti-inflammatory effect. Then comes the anti-allergic effect. It works like lunestin. It has got Lingzi-8 content, which is an anti-allergic property of its own, because it acts on the immune system. The immune system dictates the mast cell. Then the mast cell liberates the chemical factors, and this allergic phenomena is prohibited. Same way, if you come to cancer, which is the biggest killer in the world now, since 1977, it has been discovered that it is a carcinostatic. It doesn't let the cancer grow. How? By compromising the blood supply of that abnormal tissue. See, somewhere down the line, Ganoderma works like a mom and a teacher. It scans the body that if your cell, if that student or that child is not working well, the mom and the teacher excludes out of the class or out of the family. So take care of that one more. Similarly, Yarodama takes care of abnormal cells. It doesn't let it grow. And apart from that, the complications of radio and chemotherapy, it prevents the side effects. So the hand in hand, as a part of anti-cancer treatment, if you have an adjuvant supply of Ganoderma lucidum, you have a speedy recovery from cancer, and given at the right time, not later at lethal stage of cancer. You start it whenever you detect it. Why do wait for cancer? Why can't we take it not to get cancer? The beauty of all these products is not to get disease. So that's why prevention is said to be better than cure. When it comes to the organic health, may it be liver, may it be heart, the most important organ to supply the blood is the heart. After the blood vessels, I take heart as a pump station, but it is regulated by the pressures. Now, if your blood pressure is not okay, your heart is going to compromise. And Ganoderma regulates blood pressure. It has AC inhibitors like factors which lowers the blood pressure, ideally maintains it, and helps the heart to improve the oxygenation at each cell. It prevents the failure of heart, and it reduces the cholesterol, which is again a cause of atherosclerosis to go to a heart attack. I call it as a herb of spiritual potency because it improves the brain functions. It improves your sleep, it improves your memory. And when all these things, they go hand in hand, your personality develops. And you are a good person. When you are a good person, your spiritual potency is sustained. So when it comes to other systems of the body, like regulation of organ functions, the worst system that can give you a disease is your digestive system. And it is said that if your stomach is all right, if your intestine is all right, you can have a healthy life, even if the other, your other organs will not be compromised if your GIT is okay. So regulation of the alkalinity, regulation, even in hormonal balancing, it gives you a beautiful control to balance and to give you a fertility help. When it comes to the biggest disease of the world, we cannot forget diabetes. Diabetes, that means your glycemic control, your blood sugar level is out of control. Maybe the insulin is not working. Maybe it is not there. So type 1 and type 2 diabetes, both need to be taken care of at the root cell level. If the pancreas are not producing insulin, Ganoderma goes there, protects the beta cells of pancreas to give you a blood flow, which gives you a good quality insulin. And then if you have good insulin, if the insulin is lazy, not giving a good effect on the sugar, it sensitizes the insulin to make it work to have a good glycemic control. And a part of all these, if you are diabetic and having complication of diabetes, it can prevent the side effects of all those complications, like good potential repair in diabetic food, and in repair of neuropathies, and the healing ulcers of all these side chains of complications. So I may go on and on. Each organ needs a repair and a balance. So liver, heart, kidney, reproductive health, your ovaries, your testes, when they are out of control, either you don't get the pregnancy or you get a bad pregnancy, which is not sustainable. Leave apart the genetics and other things, all the factors which can give a good hormonal controls, Ganoderma is one of the best things to balance them. And once you get the disease, like nowadays, COVID-19, we need a good regeneration repair. And Ganoderma has its fourth effect after scanning, cleansing, and detoxificating, and killing the bad cells, the repairing and the regeneration of the new cells, especially in old age. It improves the functions by this and it protects cells. So the ultimate effect of the Ganoderma would be to protection of health and more so in old age. But to cut the story short, it's a powerful adaptogen, meaning non-toxic, non-specific. Overall, it normalizes the whole body and it is a protection for health and prevention of diseases. Don't forget the stress, which is the most important cause of diseases nowadays, and which is stressed is not too much stress because we have more than 12 types of stresses, but I will look for only chemical, physical, and oxidative stress, where Ganoderma is playing a great role to be an anti-stress herb. It works on your brain, it calms down the brain, and that's how the stress mediated pathologies can be prevented. Now, these are some of the evidences where I get the data from. Like this one is saying that ganoderma plays a great role in cancer. Again, an anti-inflammatory effect and the killing of the bad cells. Again, this article is proving that breast cancer treatment and in the possible mechanism of immunoregulation in human colorectal cancer, the results are there. And lots of articles, more than 1,000 articles are there. And the latest one in 2011, now the COVID-19 published by Dr. Lim, has given evidence that even for the viral effects, ganoderma can give you better results. Polysaccharides in ganoderma, they enhance your immunity. The spores of ganoderma are anti-tumorous. And the polysaccharide, again, all these researches, they give you intent of how ganoderma immunomodulates your body. How does it affect each cell of the body to prevent the disease and to care for the disease and to repair for it? So all these articles give you a support and evidence that it's not only a word of mouth. It's evidence-based fact that ganoderma has been a very fruitful organ protective herb, which gives you not only protection, it cares for each cell. May it be liver, may it be heart, may it be brain. It has all the valuable ingredients, more than 412, still yet we found more. And all these articles suggest that we can blindly have faith on ganoderma. Now, today we are talking about viruses, and ganoderma has antiviral properties, especially in children when there is low immunity. And you cannot give so much of antiviral drugs because antiviral drugs have their own side effects. But we have to give them. So what to do? You give antiviral drug, but you give an antiviral food, which is ganoderma, nusinersen. All these and the articles in hepatitis B, working in HIV, they give the protection in viruses. So multiple beneficial. So it has therapeutic plus prevention. How do we take it? How do we take ganoderma? Ganoderma is given to us in terms of in RGGL as active soluble, water soluble product, mycelium, and the full mushroom that is in powder form in some countries, and in UK you have it in RGGL capsule form, and all these other products which can take care of you right from the morning. You change your grocery to ganoderma grocery and you find soap, toothpaste entering into your system to take care of yourself. Your morning coffee, your oil, your chocolate milk for the babies, your body wash, your shampoo, your toothpaste, and your oils and the applicants, they give you a full support for prevention and when you have a disease to repair yourself. So to summarize the effects of ganoderma on human cells, it gives you immunity, it helps you to fight back and detox, it gives you life, which is key of your life, it gives you a calming effect on your brain, it maintains the balance, homeostasis, and it's all making alkaline food. It improves your circulation, and as a result, there's unlimited wellness and goodness to be a good human being. Now, this is in brief about ganoderma. Now, the second pillar of DXN to give you a reproductive health, both in infertility and in pregnancy and in diseases of reproductive health, a reproductive tract is spirulina, the blue-green algae. This blue-green algae, the word spirulina is a Latin word, 3.5 billion years old. People say that this is the first life on Earth. It is mentioned that when the Earth was drying down, it was a ball of fire. When it dried down, the cracking of the shell of Earth gave the water to come up. And this water had spirulina. Darwin, our great scientist, he has given the name spirulina. Richest source of nutrition, it's a complete source of nutrition, has more than 60 vital substances of vitamins. What you want, what you need, and for the whole of your life, it has all the essential things for a cell to grow, to sustain, to age, and to prevent. So it has been, why I'm saying so, it is not a word of mouth. Again, it is approved by WHO, ultrasound food control authorities, and food and agricultural organizations. They say it is the best food for tomorrow. 1 kg of spina equivalent in its worth of assorted vegetable content of minerals and vitamins. 1 gram of spirulina, that is one equal to 3 capsules of spirulina per day, will give you sufficient energy to sustain a cell health and cell life. So it has been awarded as the best natural food award. Even I will show you the slide that in Pakistan every year it is achieving the best food of the year award. As I was telling you, that Dr. Darwin, a German algae scientist, he discovered this green blue algae, and he studied that, and he found out that essentially it is more of a protein. It has carbohydrate, very minimal, 15 to 25%, little fat, more of minerals, especially it is known as a green blunt, iron in colloidal form, which is a very sustainable and acceptable form to your stomach, B complexes, and trace elements which sustain the cell health. For health, you need a good hemoglobin. Why? Because it carries oxygen to the cells. And for that, cells, you need a metabolism. So spirulina is the key to provide all things in one go. So especially in our field of ops and gynae, when you have a complication of oligohydramnios or intrauterine growth retardation, the most common reason is nutritional deficiency. So baby weight can be improved. Mother weight can be improved. The problems of gynae in dyspareunia, painful periods, remarkably resolved by spirulina because it has GLA. Here I must tell you that spirulina has got one of the best product of human need, GLA, which is only present in mother's milk. And the next is spirulina. No other food in the world has GLA. That's why it inhibits the synthesis of PGE1, which decreases the pain by decreasing the strength and sensitization. It can be achieved within 2 to 3 months. If you continuously take spirulina, you can prevent a lot of things. If you compare spirulina's iron content to synthetic iron, there's a lot of differences. It's natural, well-tolerated, affordable. You don't need to go to a doctor to take an iron supplement. You have a food in the house that can give you all the strength. And if you compare it to the parental iron, hazards of parental iron, the security and the natural, the economical, no admission, no supervision, it gives you an upper hand over blood transfusion, giving you a risk of HIV, hepatitis B, and it's easily available at your doorstep. As a result, we did a study on 53 patients by one of the leaders of GXN, and he said that we give a bottle of blood in 95 to 98% of the cases, we had saved 70 to 80% bottle of blood by giving GXN spirulina. What is the benefit of spirulina? It gives you energy, it improves your resistance, it improves your performance, it increases your stamina, repairs you fast, and above all, it gives you healthy skin and hair and strong nails. Supplements during, before, even if it's a supplement to help you to get pregnant. And after pregnancy, during problems of menstruation and menopause, and to the Weight Watchers, it is a very good natural slimming agent. So it's a benefit for whole family. It gives you a boost, it gives you revitalization, recovery, strength, and suitable even for the newborn baby of 3-day-old. People who are working hard, they can improve their work, they can improve their performance, they can improve their concentration, they can be alert, and we can cope up with the stressful situation if we have spirulina in the blood. People who are sports person people and they want to be fit, they can perform better by increasing power and stamina and speedy recovery. Everybody is aging. The minute you are born, you are told as you are 1 day old. So the aging process starts. So we cannot forget that every minute our cells are aging. What to say of 50 years of age, where there is a slowing down of each process, but we never want to be called as old. So it activates your body defenses in old age, give you a graceful strength, and keeps your cholesterol down so that you can have beautiful aging period. So many of the benefits, everybody wants to look beautiful. So you have a healthy skin with spirulina, you can make masks, you can have good hair because of good content of spirulina. I can give 5 days to talk spirulina's beneficial effects in its contents, because each content has got its own beautiful effect, giving you from skin to your brain the beneficial effects of the content. While traveling, you must have experienced jet lag. The content of spirulina gives you a support by giving you a concentration and a better recovery following a long journey. It's not only my personal experience, you can try that also. You carry your spirulina in your bag when you're traveling, you don't need anything else. This is one of the best things. So if you have a nutshell slide, a food exchange value of 12 candies of spirulina, the content of vitamin A, the content of vitamin E, B complexes, there's a huge lot available. The take home message is, spirulina is safe, economical, approved by the authentic societies of the world. And if you love your family, you should give spirulina to your family, because it is the best friend. It is the best biophysical insurance. Don't worry if spirulina says, I'm there to protect your family. The combination of spirulina and Ganoderma is the best combination to give you health and happiness of the cell level. Now, the third pillar, which protects your reproductive health, is Noni Morinda Citrifolia, which you must be having as Voranzyme Morinzyme. It is a health in the glass. And the traditional use of Noni goes back to thousands of, few hundreds of years in Haiti Islands. They say it protects every system, may it be digestive system, skin, bones, your urinary system. I must say it has a beautiful effect on your fertility, because it regulates your hormones. It is an alkaline solution which gives you the cell health in the balancing of your hormones. And nowadays we are talking of respiratory problems. So respiratory problems, even allergy to infections, it can help you. According to Dr. Williams, a renowned scientist, it affects all the systems of your body. So you can see all the 14 systems of your body can be benefited by Morinzyme, because it has a beautiful effect, which in combination with the Rosal in Morinzyme and with the enzymes in Morinzyme, it gives you a good support for your gut. It gives you a good support for whatever you take it. You need to have a good gut. And once you start Morinzyme, you will feel the difference. Morinzyme, as being fermented, it is a very good natural enzyme to give you a enhancement of your metabolism, digestion, absorption, regulation, and above all, in gynae, it regulates your cycle. It gives you pain-free. It is the, one of the best analgesics of the world. Its effect of analgesia has been compared by morphine. The studies just show that effect of centrally acting analgesia is compared with noni. It gives you pain of inner organs, pain relief. So it restores the balances, it restores the normality, and it takes care of infections. And that's why it helps you get fertile if the reason is infection also. In terms of obstetric care, it gives you relief of pain in the pregnancy, it gives you the effect of nausea and vomiting and constipation, contraction of the uterine, premature contractions and the bleeding after birth, and discharges in the delivery. And it is the best friend of a girl. People in the world who are models, they use spirulina and Morinzyme to beautify themselves. So they drink this juice. Some say they drink in their puberty, so their old age. It affects on respiratory system. Its effect on your GIT and its effect on your whole systems, beautify it as the best help for reproductive health. So the fourth thing that I would like to mention here is the cordyceps sinensis, one of the most expensive mushrooms of the world and most difficult to find in Himalayas. It's a caterpillar mushroom. It's the most popular in Chinese world to give you the best stamina. But when they studied it more, found that it works on the cells of the capillaries. It works on the blood cells, which enhances the oxygen like Ganoderma. So look at the vision of Dr. Lin, that he has clustered all the products which are giving similar benefits, but when combined, they give the whole strength to the whole body. So giving you a good function. See, it not so many medicines can be given in renal failure. Cordyceps can be given in renal failure to improve renal function. In chronic bronchitis, anti-aging, declining sex drive. That's why it works for infertility as well. A combination of, see, my formula of Mrs. C, Mrs. C for cordyceps, M for morency, R for rishi, S for spirulina is the best combination of the world to make you fertile, to make you happy and healthy, to have a good married life. I call it as the elixir of life. It gives you stamina, it gives you immunity, memory and concentration. Remember, it works on your capillaries. So it is working on your brain capillaries. It stimulates the sexual drive. It gives you an antioxidant properties. As it works on circulation, it works like a tonic for the lung and kidney. This the blood supply of this stress, ovaries and testes improves, it improves the fertility. And as well as when the blood supply of the uterus improves, it gives you a rise of a good pregnancy. So see how it works? It gives you a cardiovascular, circulatory, digestive, genitourinary, immune disorders covered, and metabolic and nutritional disorders covered. Reproductive disorders covered, respiratory and pulmonary disorder covered. All these are is combined in cordyceps. So nowadays we are talking about COVID. Let's see, combination of cordyceps and spirulina, rishi, tea tree cream gives you a good support against COVID-19 because it works on improve and enhance function of respiratory system. The benefit of cordyceps, well proven by a scientist from University of Hong Kong, Professor George Halpert. He said that it improves the bioenergy in animals and humans. And that's why the internal balance and mechanism and utilization of oxygen becomes more efficient. Functioning of the heart, prevention of irregular heartbeats, and sustainable survival rate of cells of the heart improvement decreases the mortality. And if people who are taking cordyceps, their heart works well. Cholesterol goes down, and the cholesterol being a cause of the atheroma, which leads to the heart attack, in combination of Ganoderma, if you take cordyceps during a cardiac situation, you can come out of it safe and sound. See, the genes nobody can change, but cordyceps is one factor, and also Ganoderma, which improves the epigenetics by repairing your DNA. And this DNA repair is not possible by any medicine. Only the food can take care of the DNA repair. And now we see that every disease is genetically coded. So can we change our epigenetics? Yes, we can, because it's like a keyboard. Once you push a key, then you execute a command. And keyboard without a touch cannot have an executed command. Like a disease in your body cannot come out if you don't push that ignition of control, which is your diet and your lifestyle. The blood cells in your blood are a reliable source of energy. They are source of your viability. So cordyceps improves this cell viability. May it be platelet, may it be WBC, may it be the stem cells in the bone marrow. It improves the function of these cells. It protects the liver by having effect on repair and regeneration. Research shows the effect on cirrhosis. Lots of research is there by improvement in cirrhosis, hepatitis, and hepatitis B. Combination of spirulina and cordyceps gives you a very good cover in hepatitis treatment. In kidneys, if you go hand in hand with the treatment of kidney diseases, the adjuvant of cordyceps sinensis, it improves the kidney diseases. In cancer, it has been seen that it improves the reduction of tumor sizes in cancer patients. 4 capsules or 6 grams of a tumor of cancer a day can have a therapeutic effect on the reduction of cancer incidence, plus the reduction in the size of the cancer. Immunity, as I told you, it works in modulation of the immune system, having increased natural killer cell activity, recharging and protecting the arming of the immunity. Several scientific data is there for this evidence, improvement of the immune system. And then Last but not the least, fast aging supplement known to mankind. It improves in the reduction of fatigue, coldness, dizziness, respiratory and breathing problems also. And again, beautiful antioxidant. Why Dixon cordyceps? Because comparison of other cordyceps and Dixon cordyceps, lots of things can be compared. It's pure. Tablets form organically cultivated. Quality control, it is GMP approved. And no chemical additives, no preservatives. Easy to digest, easy to prepare. The references goes back all this natural product research, which you can get hold and keep on studying. Nothing will be less or more, but I have tried to compose some little bit of key points so that you can give, just like a frame. You can put in the details by studying it more on PubMed or on the search articles. You don't want to be sick. You don't want to die sick. We want to have a healthy, beautiful living when we are not born, and we want to have a healthy, beautiful living when we age and we leave this world. We leave this world with the beauty of living like a legend. It can be only possible when you have all these products at your doorstep and in your grocery. How to use it? All this you know, but I just to revise, you can take 1 gram to 6 gram per sheer day, depending on the requirement. You can take it in any form in terms of coffee and cocozy. Spirulina, you can take as maximum as you like. But if you are in a disease state, you can increase the dose maybe to a few grams per day. And Morinzi as per your desire. Cordyceps 2 to 4 minimum a day. Limonene, I didn't mention because of time permit. Pineapple and cordyceps together gives you a very beautiful beverage. Tea tree creams give you a good sanitizer. Instead of an alcohol scented sanitizer, if you use tea cream, it gives you a sustained antiviral effect. It's a beautiful, 400 articles are there on tea tree cream. And Potenzi is not there in your countries, but it is also a very good product for preservation of fertility. And these are a few of the slides from my own country to let you know that we have been awarded persistently since 2010 by the Prime Minister as a brand ambassador, brand award to Spirulina. And this is the way to achieve your health for your family, for yourself, and a sustained, beautiful age.